Hey everybody, welcome back to Living Between Paychecks Kitchen. It's the other host, Jack. And I bet you were expecting Oz, weren't you? But, well, no, today's gonna be me. And I have some other videos lined up too, so hope you'll see me more often. And maybe even some extra bonus videos in the week instead of just the normal Tuesday, Friday. Try and chop in some extra videos for you guys. Alright, so anyway, today we are making some toaster oven roasted garlic cauliflower. Our actual oven's broke, so we're using the toaster oven. It's going to be roasted in some garlic and olive oil, and we're going to have this really nice dipping sauce on the side. And also, it's going to be keto, so if you're into the keto diet thing, this will be great for you. So let's go ahead and get right into it. Alright, here's our ingredients. Don't worry about why the cutting boards are like that. That's just how it is. Main ingredient is going to be your head of cauliflower. This is only $2.77. 4 cloves of nicely and finely chopped garlic. And for the sauce, you're going to need some mayo, well, half a cup of mayo, some sauce. This actually calls for sriracha, but I'm not a fan of sriracha, so I'm substituting with Cholula. Some lime juice, and some sour cream, which we're using about half a cup of. So half a cup of mayo, half a cup of sour cream, and then like a tablespoon or two of lime and something like that. We'll get into it later. So yeah, let's go ahead and get into chopping up the cauliflower. So we need to start separating the cauliflower into the individual florets. This might be easy to do with a knife, but for the most part, you can really do it with your hands. Now, you can keep these as whole chunks if you want, or you can break them down into their individual stemmy pieces. I'm going to go for the chunks at the moment, but I might change that later. Now, yeah, just go ahead and break off all the pieces and put them in your mixing bowl. You're also going to add your garlic and some olive oil to it as well, and some salt and pepper, but we'll get to that when we get there. Alright, now that our florets are all broken up into both small and big pieces, I kind of went for a little mixture. Go ahead and add them to your mixing bowl. I'm going to go ahead and do it real quick off camera. Next, go ahead and pour in your olive oil. The recipe called for 4 tablespoons. I went ahead and went with 5 because I figured this was quite a bit of cauliflower. And then next, we're going to add our garlic. Let me bring this into focus here. Add the chopped garlic, sprinkle it in there, and where did my salt and pepper go? Salt and pepper to taste. I'm not going to use too much salt, I'm not a big fan of it. And stir it up really well. I'm going to try and use this thing to stir it and see how well that works. Now, pretty much just mix it until your cauliflower, God, I have such a hard time saying the word cauliflower. Mix everything together until you have your cauliflower and your garlic mixed and the oil covering everything. Go ahead and take your time with it. You're not in a hurry. Also, if you want, you can season it here if you really, really wanted to add some things like chili powder or cayenne powder or some barbecue seasoning to it. But I think that might be a bit unnecessary for this, specifically because of the dipping sauce we're going to be using at the end. All right, everything is coated enough for me. I'm going to go ahead and actually, I might add a little bit more pepper. There we go. Okay, now once you have everything fully mixed to satisfaction, go ahead and add it to your baking sheet. Ignore that my baking sheet already has stuff on it. It's not like I had to do 2 takes of this for some reason. Oops, some garlic kind of floated around and did its own thing. Sprinkle that on if you have any that's just chilling in there. Okay, now once you have it on here, go ahead and set your oven to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Well, I guess you could have done this earlier technically. And you're going to cook this for 25 to 30 minutes, and you're going to flip it halfway through. Also leave it uncovered as well. So let's go ahead and do that. Alright, so while the cauliflower is baking, let's go ahead and make the sauce. So we need 8 ounces. I'm going to zero out my scale. We need 8 ounces of sour cream. And we're going to need 8 ounces of mayo. So let me go ahead and add that together real fast. I accidentally dropped some. Well, that sucks. There we go, 8.1 ounces. Let me put that back in there. And we need 8 ounces of mayo. Maybe I should use a larger bowl. I probably should have maybe used a larger bowl. I think it'll be okay though. Just don't stir too viciously. Really close to 16 ounces together. All right, there we go. half a cup mayo. Wait a minute. Okay, so remember earlier when I said half a cup of mayo and half a cup of sour cream? Well, about that, I went ahead and made a cup of each. We're just gonna roll with it though. I don't want to toss this. We're just doubling, I guess you could say. All right, now we need 2 teaspoons of lime juice. So 2 teaspoons of lime juice. And we need a tablespoon of sauce. Hopefully I have enough left in here for those. It actually wants more. When it wants 2 tablespoons, but I don't think I have 2 tablespoons worth of it. Well, I'm out of Cholula. 1.5 tablespoons is what you got. And just mix it together. Find a big fork and just mix it. All right, so here's the dipping sauce that I accidentally doubled the recipe of. There's only actually supposed to be half this much. And now the only thing we're waiting on to finish is the cauliflower. All right, here's our end product after baking for 27 minutes. With 10 minutes left, I went ahead and took it out and tossed it around a little bit and put it back in, let it finish cooking. Here's the sauce up close, by the way. And so yeah, we're gonna go ahead and let it cool off, and then we're gonna go ahead and try it out on camera. All right, I got a small piece here. Let's go ahead and give it a try with the sauce, or the dip, I guess you could say. Let's get a decent bit on there. Don't drop it. That's pretty good. I wish I had more Cholula. It adds a really nice tang to it, but I really need some more Cholula, especially with the lime. It's great stuff. Yeah, it's a pretty good party shareable. Now that we're coming out of the end times, I guess you could say. Yeah, it's actually not that bad. Especially considering I don't eat cauliflower all that much. Unless it's pickled and spicy. Spicy pickled cauliflower is a bomb. It's a great shareable. Tastes good. It's easy to make. It's not very difficult at all. So yeah. Thanks for watching. You're probably going to start seeing us in slightly more often than just Tuesday and Friday. I'm going to try and get extra videos out to compliment all that Oz is making. And so, yeah, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.